to this one story about the ideal of Miss Sarah Brown, this sort of prim Salvation Army worker who kind of learns, you know, finds romance for the first time with a gambler. And very interesting thing about Lesser and his talent was, you know, they were normally you would have the book written first for the musical, the libretto and everything, and then the composer would kind of stick songs here, stick songs there, but they were struggling with it. They couldn't come up with it. He saw all these characters and he just started writing songs before there was actually really a book. And they suddenly stopped, they looked at all these songs that got, and so they just built this book around all these wonderful songs with a few revisions here and there, but that's how gifted he was. Anyway, it opened 1950, and it's a love letter to Broadway itself, and of course one of the most perfect creations of the Broadway musical indeed. So, when you see a guy reach for stars in the sky, you can bet that he's doing it for some doll. When you spot a John Wayne out in the rain, chances are he's insane, as only a John can be for a Jane. When you meet a gent paying all kinds of rent for a flat that could flatten the Taj Mahal, call it sad, call it funny, it's better than even money. That the guy's only doing it for some doll, some doll, some doll. The guy's only doing it for some doll. Of course, the opening got the gamblers. I got the horse right here. The name is Paul Revere, and he's a guy that says the weather's clear, can do, can do. The guy says the horse can do. He says the horse can do. On the morning line, the guy's got it figured at 5 or 9. Has chance, the guy says the horse has chance. If he says the horse has chance, has chance. Look at epitaph, he went to buy a hat. This here in the telegraph, big threats, big threats. Plot lines. You've got Miss Sarah Brown, part of the Salvation Army. Follow the hole and stray no more, stray no more, stray no more. Put down the bottle and we'll say no more. Follow, follow the fold. And of course she's spotted by Sky Masterson, who bets that he can get her to go to Havana with him. The other couple, an ecstasyist, better known as a stripper, named Miss Adelaide. Loves Nathan. I love you. A bush of land of Beck. A bush of land of Beck. And a hug around the neck. A hug around the neck. And a barrel and a heap. A barrel and a heap. And I'm talking in my sleep about you. About you. A hard sleep and a half trouble sleep. Because I love you. A bush of land of Beck. Beck's pretty neck. I do. Masterson, of course, comes on to Miss Sarah. And things start sparking from both ends. Who knows? I'll know when my love's along. I'll know then and there. I'll know at the sight of her face how I care, how I care, how I care. And I'll stop and I'll stare at that face in the throng. Yes, I'll know when my love comes along. Meanwhile, Adelaide has developed this little condition because of being engaged to Nathan for 14 years. She's reading a textbook to try to figure out what's the matter with her. The average unmarried female, basically insecure, due to some long frustration, may react with psychosomatic symptoms, difficult to endure, affecting the upper respiratory track. In other words, from waiting around for that plain little band of gold, a person will develop a cold. You can spray her wherever you figure the streptococci lurk. You can give her a shot, whatever she's got, but it just won't work. If getting the fisheye from the hotel clerk. A person can develop a cold. It says here, a female remaining single, just in the legal sense, shows a neurotic tendency. See note. Note, chronic organic symptoms, toxic or hypertense, involving the eye, the ear, the nose, and throat. In other words, from worrying whether the wedding is on or off, a person can develop a cough. You can feed her all day with the vitamin A and the Promo Fizz. The medicine never gets anywhere near where the trouble is. She's getting the kind of a name for herself, the name ain't his. A person can develop a cough. And furthermore, stalling the wedding trip. A person can develop like grip. When they get on the train in Niagara, she can hear church bells chime. The compartment's air-conditioned, and the mood sublime. Then they get off at Saratoga for the 14th time. A person can develop la grip, with the wheezes, the sneezes, a sinus that's really up to from a lack of community property, a feeling she's getting too old. A person can develop a bad, bad,